inviting me. Actually, I'm a former young care as well. I'm about to become 40. But what's important to underline is that I come from a long journey being a young carer and becoming an active change agent. I wanted to turn my story into something to change some things in Italy. And this is the achievement we made. And it was creating our own association, the first one created by and for children of parents with a mental illness. It was cooperating with other organizations who were not created by and for is helpful, but there was a piece missing to the complete picture. So giving voice directly to those who had the real experience, who can decide what's the priorities, was key. And also to have an organization to stand up for our rights and our requirements in front of the institutions. And only an NGO could make this possible. So it's a kind of a difficult journey, but it was needed. And here I would like to present you some of the people who reach out to my organization with their own stories. What COMIP permitted was that many people recognize themselves, and so they reach out to us and to write their own experience. Someone told that there are many adolescents who have a parent with mental illness, and they are alone, and they would need psychological support and more. And this comes directly from a former young carer. Another young carer from Italy, sorry, I don't know why it goes so fast. She said that it would be fundamental to receive assistance to enter the labor market and society in general. In my case, after an entire lifetime living in a world created by my parents' illness, it was difficult to learn to live in the outside world. So she would have benefited from more help in this regard. Another one pointed out that she was surprised when our organization finally was spoken about in the news. In Italy, there's no awareness at all, very little about young carers, but about children of parents with mental illness, it's really as a starting point. And we are advocating with the media also to present in a correct way, because there is a lot of sensationalism when there are crimes, and they always point out the mental health problems, and this is not helpful at all. So we want to bring the voices also of the positive, and so to educate media how to cover this topic. Another young adult carer, she wrote a message after her mother committed suicide for the third time, and she reached out to us by email. And she said, I need someone to make me feel I'm not alone. I don't know to whom to speak about that. And thank you, I need your help. And so she found our online support group for peers, and there she could find others to talk about this without being judged. And this is another young adult carer, and she discovered what a psychiatric illness is when she was 12. And while growing up, what was hardest was communicating to others about this topic, because people could hardly understand what it meant. And so she said, now that I'm grown up, I want people to talk about it, because if we don't talk about it, we are not facing it. And so it's important to be open, but preparing society to not create negative outcomes when you speak about your personal experience. These are some of the challenges that you could face when being a young carer for a parent with mental health. You could be in charge of household tasks, be in between a parental conflict, being bullied. You should be the emotional supporter for your parents. And also, you could have to deal with doctors, hospitals, and in case of emergency, you are the first one being there, so if something bad happened to your parent, you have to call yourself emergency. And this is a picture, a frame from a movie, A Woman Under the Influence by John Cassavetes. And this is a scene that can picture what a child can do when he or she witnesses the situation at all. Mom is unwell, she or he is depressed, hears voices, looks into the void, says weird things, doesn't sleep at night, scares me. And you can imagine how hard this could be if you don't have anyone to explain you what is happening or to talk about it. And so this is another frame from a short movie, The Wish Fort by Lisa Ford. And this is, what about me? What can I do? Where can I turn to for help? And where can I be safe? Who can explain to me what is happening? With whom can I talk about how I feel? And this is something that we have to learn people to understand, because in other families, maybe these are not issues arising, so it's important to build support among the larger society as well. So why is it so important to offer young carers a safe environment where they can express how they feel and not being judged? They might feel shame, stigma, sense of guilt, loneliness, family loyalty, and confusion. And you believe often that you're the only one living this situation. And this is not the case, but if no one talks about that, you think you're the only one. And also, you don't feel like your experience and point of view are completely understood. Even if you try to talk to someone, if they don't have the same experience, they can try to, but it's not the same as talking with peers about that. And what could help? How many young carers are there? In Italy, we don't know. Each EU country should invest in an extensive national research to identify them. We should train professionals from many fields and work together, creating multi-professional equips, including former young carers, to address their needs on a local and national level. We should have media campaigns.